In child's pose. So bring your knees as far apart as feels comfy. Yeah. So facing this way first. So that way your knees and your ankles will be on the mat. Yeah. Good. And then you can either bring your bolster out, even though I did tell you to put your bolster on the other side, you can either bring your bolster out in front and relax down onto it, or just walk the hands all the way out in front if your hips and thighs feel all right already. Yeah. If when you come into this pose without the bolster though, if you already feel like, oh, really, really tight in the inner thighs, just bring your knees a little closer together or take the bolster so you've got something to rest on. Yeah. Either bring the forehead to the ground or a cheek. And then let the hips soften back. Let the glute muscles relax. And as you release down into this pose, feel like your energy sort of moving forward as well. So the chest, rather than just collapsing down, is also moving slightly forward. So we're continually creating space in the body. Allow the eyes to close. Just softly. Start to tune in. Start to focus on your breath. Everything that's happened today, letting it go. No longer important for this moment. See if you can have full attention and awareness on the breath. See if every inhale, maybe, you can expand the ribs. And every exhale, making an effort to draw your belly button into the spine, compressing out every last bit of old air. If you have your cheek to one side of your bolster, just turn it to the other side. If you have your forehead down, just leave it. See if you can relax through the shoulders just a little more. And soften through the elbows so the arms aren't doing any work. Every time the mind drifts or wanders, just gently encouraging it back to the breath. And even if your mind thinks this is the perfect time to remind you of something that happened 5 years ago, or something that you have to do next week, you might be running through lists that you need to check off. Just come back to your breath. See if you might be able to catch just one more inhale and one more exhale before your mind drifts again. Eventually, with practice, when we gently draw our attention and focus back to the breath, it becomes easier and easier. But it takes time. We're different every day. So if your mind is really wandering today, that's totally fine. So every time you notice this, come back to the breath. Take a deep breath in through the nose, out through the mouth. And use your inhale slowly, slowly, sitting back up, walking your hands in towards your knees, bringing the knees together, and this time taking the feet wide. So you might need your bolster here, you might need your block. Maybe the block goes underneath your butt for the hero pose. Maybe the bolster comes close to your lower back. So if you're going to recline backwards, maybe the bolster is behind you so you have something to rest on, yeah? Move slow and close your eyes. So then that way it doesn't matter what anyone else is doing and you will feel it. If it feels enough of a stretch sitting up, stay, yeah? If there's a little more room for you, maybe start to recline down. Good.
You can recline all the way down if you want.
Keep the knees gently drawing towards each other. Down onto the ground. The eyes are closed. The face is soft. If at any time you feel pain or like a pinching, a stinging, a burning in the knee, this is a really, really good indication that maybe you've gone a little far today. In the tops of the feet too. Cramp there as well. So never push your body. This is not a race. This is not competitive. You don't need to be better than the person next to you, and you don't need to be better than the person you were yesterday. You're a different person. So it might mean sitting up higher. It might mean reclining back more. Choose wisely in choosing this moment. It's not a super long pose. Just stay with your breath. If your mind is trying to trick you out of the pose, so we avoid sensation or feeling, it might tell you to shift or move or fidget or fuss. Breathe deeper. Breathe more controlled and more steady. Take one last deep breath in. Exhale it out. And then just as slowly as you recline down, start to make your way back up. Nice and slow. Good. Bring your butt over to one side and then take the butterfly legs. So soles of the feet together. You can take your block under your butt or your bolster under your butt. Doesn't matter. And then just little pulses with the knees to create a little bit of space in the hips. Just to relax through the inner thighs. And you can keep the chin tucked into the chest if that's nice. Maybe circles with the neck. Feels great just to release. See if you can lengthen through the spine just a little bit more as you make these pulses, rather than sort of like bowing out into the lower back. Keep everything up nice and tall. Allow your little pulses to slow down until your knees are just heavy out to the sides. Feel both of your glute muscles relax. So usually one is a little tighter than the other. And this might mean that one of our knees is up a little higher than the other. So it could be a big difference depending on if we like sit to one side a lot during the day or if we sort of slouch or slump. It could be a super subtle difference. So close your eyes and then focus on your glute muscles, the parts of your body that's touching the mat. And just notice, is there a little more tension in the right or the left? Maybe you can relax. Just a little more. And then take your awareness to like the top part of your legs and see what part of them is touching the ground. Are they even on both sides? Maybe you can feel the distance of how far each knee is off the ground. And when we really tune in, really, really tune in, maybe you can notice the subtle differences in the body. We're not drawing our awareness here to judge them and be like, yeah, I knew my right side was terrible. But just so we can notice, just so we're aware. So often we move through the poses not really aware of our body at all, like just going through the motions, autopilot. So tune in. Deep breath in through the nose. Sigh it out through the mouth. And allow the eyes to open. And then just straighten the right leg out to the side as much as it will go, yeah? So that way the ankle is on the ground, or even if you're not, the floor's really nice, so it probably doesn't matter, yeah? And then bring the hands out in front. So flex your right toes. You want to be able to feel the activation through both the front and the back of your leg. We'll just run through a few cat-cow poses here. So inhale, the chest comes forward, yeah? And then lift up as you squeeze the elbows in. And then on the exhale, round through the spine, chin to chest. Awesome. So just making the movements in the spine, your breath, inhale, come forward. Good. Draw the shoulders away from the ears. And then on the exhale, rounding back. Good. Belly button in and chin to chest. When you roll forward on your inhale, notice though if your right butt lifts up off of the ground. And if it does, suck it down. Yeah. Awesome. And then continue to flow through these two movements, slow and steady with the breath. Staying focused on what you're doing, and notice as soon as the mind drifts, if the right leg just becomes a little bit lax. Maybe it becomes a little bit floppy. So keep it active, but just as active as it needs to be. Deepening the breath to deepen the movements. Take one more inhale. One more exhale as you round. Inhale, come back to center. Nice. Both legs back into the butterfly. And then straighten out through the left. Different side. Maybe it goes a little further. Maybe it doesn't. And then flex the toes. So they point directly up to the ceiling. That way the hip is in alignment. It's not rotating out or in. And the knee's better protected. Both butts, anchor them to the ground. And then reach the hands out in front. But so making the same movements again. Inhale. Good. Arching through the spine. Draw the shoulder blades together. And then exhale. Rounding through the spine. Chin to chest. And kind of like push the ground away from you. We'll get a little bit more space in the upper back. Continue to flow. Keeping the butt anchored. And keeping the left leg active enough. Just so you feel that energy moving through the leg. Maybe close the eyes. So the attention comes inwards. Doesn't matter about what it looks like or how bendy your spine is, how far you reach forward or how far you arch, but it matters what it feels like. But feel it. Allow yourself to breathe in deeply to create space. And then trust yourself enough to breathe out completely, not needing to hold on to anything. One last inhale. One last exhale. And inhale, come back to center. Awesome. Straighten both legs out. So both of them out to the side. I like my legs don't stretch very far apart. So if when you stretch your legs out, one heel is off of the mat, just take your butt off. And then that way both of the heels will be a bit more protected on the mat. I don't know. I just think it feels a little bit nicer. But the floor's soft, so it's up to you. Yeah. Good. A few cat-cow movements and then we're going to pause in a forward fold, yeah? So you choose. Flex the toes back towards your body so both legs are nice and active. Hands are out in front. Good. Inhale for your semi-cow pose, I guess. And then exhale to round. So each time we inhale, we're coming a little closer towards the ground. And inhale, bring the body a little closer. And then exhale to arch. So we're all going to pause in a forward fold. Whenever you're ready, but take as many little cat-cow variations as feels good for you. So let your body warm up. Let your body soften. And then even when you come to your forward fold, it doesn't have to be a completely still pose. You can breathe in and sort of lift and lengthen the chest. And then when you breathe out, maybe that's where there's a little bit more room to reach the hands more forward. Or to lower the hips a little closer. Good. So if anything is coming to the ground, it's going to be the belly first, rather than the head. And that way we know that the spine is nice and long. We're not putting any pressure on the lower back. Keeping the chest nice and open makes it so much easier for the breath. So don't be so concerned with getting the head down. Be more concerned about getting a deep, full breath. And be more concerned about how your inner thighs feel. If they feel like a rubber band that is about to snap, really good indication that maybe you've gone a little far today, so take them in a little closer. Close your eyes once you come to your forward fold and you're still. And breathe. Every inhale, feel that length in the spine. Every exhale, feel that softening through the hips. Keeping the legs just as active as they need to be. Nice. One more deep breath in. Slow breath out. Awesome. Use your inhale slowly, slowly, slowly. Come back up. Yeah. point the toes. Maybe bring the feet in just a little bit closer and bring the hands behind. So lifting the chest up, keep the butt on the ground first and then point your toes, you know, like a ballerina, I guess. Yeah, just so we flex them the other way. And then lift the chest a little bit more up towards the ceiling. Maybe take the gaze up. So you can stay here with your butt anchoring down, the chest lifting up. If it feels good for you, lift the butt and hips up. So we're kind of in like a starfish pose, I guess. It might feel great, it might not feel great for your wrists. Keep the legs active. Yeah. Keep the neck long, inhale. And exhale if the butt's lifted, slowly lower down. Draw the legs back in towards each other. Nice and slow, point and flex, point and flex. Yeah. Nice. And then bend the knees. Take the feet a little bit wider, toes out, heels in. Lift up off of the butt and come into our little Indo squat. Yeah. Look towards the heels, inner arches. And lift them up off of the mat rather than compress down into them. Yeah. So anchor the big toe, anchor the pinky toe, the heel, and then lift up, find space in the inner arch. Feel your butt reaching lower towards the ground and your chest reaching just a little bit higher. Yeah, deep breath in. Deep breath out as the shoulders drop, maybe the butt and hips drop just a little bit more. And again, like that, inhale, lift up, feel yourself lengthening. Exhale, breath, maintain that height, but feel the hips sink. One more. And exhale. We bring the hands out in front. Toes face forward. Inhale, lift the butt and hips. And then exhale to forward fold. Let the head be heavy. Nice. Keep the feet parallel towards each other. And they're probably a little bit wider than hip distance. Then make any little movements that feel nice. So you could pedal the feet out here. You could gently sway the head from side to side. You might sway the hips, shoulders, head, neck, arms. Just whatever feels right in your body. Keep the knees bent, so this will keep the quads active. Good. Protecting through the hamstrings. And keep your core muscles engaged. So this will help to better protect the lower back. There's not so much weight then hanging off of it. We have that core engagement to protect ourselves. Yeah. Nice, guys. Coming into your forward fold, just letting the body hang. And then starting to take the feet a little bit further apart. So a little bit further apart. Toes are sort of facing in a little bit. They could be facing forward, yeah, but maybe in just a little bit helps. And then with the feet, squeeze them towards each other. So you might need your block. Maybe your hands out in front are enough. Inhale, lift halfway. So up onto the fingertips or on your palms, it doesn't matter. Stick your butt back. Yes, reach your chest forward and then bring your thumbs to touch. So we're coming into a twist here. The right hand, inhale, sweeps all the way up towards the ceiling. So your right hand. Yeah, nice, guys. Continue to lengthen through the spine and continue to draw your feet towards each other. So I had a teacher in this pose that used to come around and like press on our thighs. So if I was to come and press on like your quad muscles today, they would be active, yeah? So we're not just dumping into the stretch, but we're keeping the body active. We're keeping the energy moving evenly through it. One more inhale. Exhale and lower down. We're moving to the other side. So both of your hips stay super stable. Yeah, and then lift the left hand up. Press your butt even further back. Reach the crown of the head, yes, more forward. So you're lengthening the spine long ways and then you're lengthening the arms out in both directions. Good, squeezing the legs together, engaging through the quads. Draw the shoulder blades a little bit more. Feel the breath moving effortlessly. Deep breath in. And exhale, lower down. Nice, guys. Inhale, halfway lift. And exhale to fold. Good. Walk the hands all the way towards the top of your mat. Pivot the toes to face the front. Yes. Nice. And then sink down into your lizard pose. So bend into your front knee. Awesome. Keep your back heel lifted and then really press back. So both of your hands are on the inside of your left foot. So both hands are on the inside. Yeah, perfect. And then really press back with your right heel. So more press. And then as much as you're pressing back, sink into the left knee. Good. Then you can either drop the left, the right knee down, sorry, if that feels better, but keep the leg active. You can drop down into your forearms if that feels better. Keep the hips low and the chest higher though. So feel the hips sink and then perk your chest up just a little bit. So the spine stays nice and long. And then continue to lengthen. So continue to press through your front knee. Continue to activate through your back leg. Also as slow and steady breath. Good. One more inhale. One more exhale. Nice. And then from here, we're walking all the way around to the other side. So just lift your back knee, pivot the toes to face the windows, and walk the hands all the way around towards the back, lizard on the other side. So lengthen first. Both hands are on the inside of the right foot, and then press strongly back through your left heel. Lift the back knee and then sink into the right knee. So the energy is moving evenly through both of your legs. Take a deep breath in. On the exhale, if you want to drop the left knee, drop it down. If you don't, keep it lifted. It's your choice. But just keep that activation through the back leg. And you can still do that when the knee is down. And then you choose. If you want to drop to your elbows, drop to your elbows. Feel your shoulders, though, drawing together. And then lift the chest just a little bit. Keep your chin tucked in. Yeah, that's nice, though, with the shoulders. Do you feel it? Yeah. Good. So the spine stays nice and long. And then breathe. Breathe into the hip. Breathe into your thigh. Feel that length through the spine. Nice. Deep breath in. Deep breath out. Good. If you're down on your forearms, come back up onto your palms. Good. Walk the hands all the way back to the windows. Tuck the toes in. Or tuck them in. What is that, like pigeon toe the toes? Deep breath in here to lengthen. And then exhale to forward fold. So letting the head come down towards the ground. Take your hands wherever you like. The palms could be flat on the ground with your elbows squeezing in. Maybe you reach your hands all the way towards the door. Doesn't matter where your arms go. Use them for support. And then bring your body weight just a little bit more forward. So a little bit more into the balls of the feet. Not so they're gripping or clinging, but just so the weight is even. And that way the hips stack a little bit more over the heels. As much as your head is reaching down, press your butt higher. Great, guys. Feel that length in the spine and that strength through your legs. Keep the quads engaged. Keep your feet gently squeezing towards each other. Perfect. One more inhale. One more exhale. And bring your hands to your hips. And then inhale, use your core strength all the way up to standing. Yeah. Good. Your front toes, turn them towards the front, so the left leg. Yeah. And then bend into the left knee, setting up for warrior two pose. Take the hands out nice and wide. Good. And the same deal with the feet. They're pressing into the ground, but squeeze them towards each other. Yeah. And then sink a little bit lower. Nice. Look towards the ground first in your warrior two pose. So just look directly down and feel that connection to the earth. Feel super grounded, steady and strong. Good. Then take the gaze over the left fingertips. So we lengthen out. Feel both arms nice and strong. Deep breath in. Exhale, flip the front palm and reverse. Stay nice and low in your warrior legs. Yeah. Inhale, come back, warrior two pose. Exhale, side angle. Left forearm, left thigh, reach the right arm all the way overhead. Yes. Inhale, warrior two. Straighten the front leg. Exhale, reverse. Good. So nice and straight through the front leg, reach. Inhale. Exhale, triangle pose. Straight left leg. Reach, 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 reach. And then bring the left hand down wherever it touches. Right hand reaches high. Good. Tuck your butt under just a little and lean the chest back, or the upper back, I guess, back into the pose. And notice how much weight is in your left hand. If that's where all your weight is, see if you can just soften a little bit. Your left hand is just the guide. Use your core strength more. Inhale, come back up.
Exhale, bend the front knee, hands come down, pivot on the back toes into our lizard pose again. So sink nice and low. Yeah, good, nice and low. Deep breath in. Deep breath out. From here, we're coming to three-legged dog, yeah? So lift your left toes or your left foot off of the mat. Keep the knee into the elbow. Nice. And then on the exhale, press all the way back and up. Three-legged dog, opening the left hip. So bring your heel close to your left bum and bring the knee higher up towards the ceiling. Spread your fingers wide. Feel your chest gently pressing back towards your thighs.
Could you feel my hand coming for you?
Nice. Breath is slow, steady, deep and even. One more inhale. And then on the exhale, take a big step forward outside of your left hand. Big step forward outside of the left hand. Nice. Walk the hands all the way back into the center. Pigeon toe the toes in a little. Inhale to lengthen. Exhale to forward fold. Squeeze the legs. Head comes maybe a little closer towards the ground. Maybe it doesn't. So if your head comes effortlessly to the ground with the legs wide, you can take the legs a little closer. So obviously the closer the legs are, the further away from the ground you have to go. The wider your legs are, the closer your head is going to come. Bring the body weight just a little bit more forward. Lift your butt and hips. Feel the head sinking down. Deep breath in. Deep breath out. Good. Bring the hands to the hips. Inhale, lengthen, lift the chest as you come all the way up to standing. Yeah, good. Back toes, so the right ones face towards the back. And then bend into the front knee, setting up for our warrior two. Good, lengthen the arms out. First, look down. So really ground down. Feel your feet, every part of your feet that's touching the ground, and then squeeze them towards each other. Good. So that'll bring so much more energy into the pose. And then look forward directly over the right fingertips. Lengthen out. Deep breath in. On the exhale, flip the front palm reverse. Stay nice and low in your warrior. Inhale, come back, warrior two. Exhale for side angle. Right forearm, right thigh. Reach the left arm up and over. And inhale, warrior two. Straighten through the front leg. Exhale, reverse. Right hand reaches up. Yeah. Inhale, come back. Exhale, triangle pose. Reach, 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 reach with the right hand. And as the right hand comes down, the left hand comes up. Perfect. Lean a little back into the upper back. And then tuck your butt under just a little tiny bit. Again, notice how much weight is in the right hand. And if you're really slumping into that, it means our core is not really doing anything. Our legs are probably not doing anything. So more activation through the legs, more activation through the core muscles. Awesome. Deep breath in. Slow breath out. Inhale, come back. Exhale, bend the front knee, bring the hands down inside of the front toes into our lizard. Good. So sink nice and low first. Good. Deep breath in. Deep breath out. Coming into three-legged dog from here. So first just lift the right toes. And then exhale, press all the way back to three-legged dog and open the right hip. Yeah. Make any little movements if you need to. Bring the heel closer and closer towards the bum. So the more you bring your heel towards your bum, the more of a thigh stretch you're going to get. The more you lift your knee, the deeper the opening through the hip flexor is going to be. So you choose. Don't go so far that you feel a cramp, but just so you feel that stretch. Deep breath in. And then on the exhale, take a big step again outside of the right hand. Walk the hands back into the center. Got one more wide-legged forward fold. So deep breath in. And then exhale to fold. So maybe you take your legs a little wider this time. Maybe you bring your legs a little closer together, yeah? And then lift the butt high. Reach the head down. Keep the energy in the legs. The inner thighs squeezing towards each other. The knees drawing up so the quads are active. The breath is the most important thing. It's slow, it's steady, it's full. Deep breath in. And slow breath out. Good.
backward. Inhale, lift halfway. On the exhale, walk the hands all the way to the front of the mat. All the way to the front of the mat. Yeah. Good. Step towards the top of the mat. And then exhale to forward fold. Let the head be nice and heavy. Doesn't matter if your big toes are touching or your feet are apart. Just so long as they're parallel. And then any little movements that feel nice. Keeping the knees just that little bit bent. Quads are active. Hamstrings are protected this way. The head is heavy. And the butt, you know the bit of the butt that you sit on? Lift that, like perk that up a little bit more towards the ceiling and you'll feel the stretch like right in the middle of the hamstring. Yeah. Nice. Let the hands dangle down in front, bend the knees a ton. Inhale, sweep up through chair pose, all the way to standing. And exhale, hands into the center of the chest. Interlace your fingers together, push the palms forward and up, inhale. Exhale, take a little bend towards the right. Maybe press the hips just a little bit to the left. Inhale, center. And exhale all the way the other side. Good. Inhale, center. Exhale, can trim the hips and fold. Come all the way back down. Nice and slow. Good. Halfway lift, just one breath. Exhale and fold. Plant the palms any way you like. Come back to plank or chaturanga. Stepping, jumping, hopping, floating. Nice. Flowing through. Or not through your vinyasa. We're all meeting in downward dog, so if you want to skip the vinyasa, please do. If you don't, move with purpose, with control. Take as long as you need. Yeah, deep breath in. Slow breath out. On your inhale, the right leg lifts, three-legged dog. On the exhale, bend the right knee, open the hips up. So bring your heel close to your bum. And then lift the knee maybe just a little bit higher. Yeah. Press your chest just a little bit back. Inhale. Exhale, take a big step forward. Big step forward to the top of the mat. High lunge. Inhale, sweep both of the hands up towards the ceiling. And tuck your butt under just a little bit. And reach the hands a little higher. Inhale. And exhale, hands come down either side of your front foot. Good. Inhale, step forward, top of the mat, and then exhale to fold. Yeah, let the head hang nice and heavy. Perfect. Inhale, lift halfway. Exhale to fold. Bend the knees a ton through chair pose to standing. Inhale. And exhale, center of the chest. If you remember which way you interlace your fingers, do it the other way. So maybe like one pinky finger feels like it's too many. And then cross the thumbs the other way. Yeah. Good. And then press forward and up. Inhale. Exhale, side bend towards the right. Maybe press the hips to the left. Center, inhale. Exhale to the other side. Get nice and long through both sides. Inhale, center. And exhale, hinge from the hips forward. Hold nice and slow all the way down. Halfway lift, one breath. Exhale and fold. Plant the palms, step or jump or hop or float, hover, whatever you like, back to plank or chaturanga. Inhale for cobra or up dog. And then when you're ready, all meeting in downward facing dog. Not a rush in the world. Your body, your practice, so you choose. Deep breath in your downward dog. Maybe sigh out through the mouth. Inhale, the left leg lifts up, three-legged dog. On the exhale, bend the left knee, open the hips. And bring your heel even closer towards your bum. Yeah, chest presses maybe just a little further back. Deep breath in. On the exhale, take a big step forward, top of the mat. And on your inhale breath, lift the hands up towards the ceiling, high lunge. Feel your shoulders drawing down and away from the hips. Inhale, reach up a little more. And exhale, hands come down either side, front foot. Inhale, step forward. And exhale to fold. Yeah. Give the shoulders a little shimmy. Give the head a little sway from side to side. Maybe pedal the feet. Yeah, anything that feels good here. Awesome. Separate the feet just a little bit, probably hip distance, I guess. Yeah, nice one. And then from here, bring your right fingertips, or just any good way, right fingertips. Hook them around your right big toe. Yeah. Left hand, left hip. Good. On your inhale, stand up. Bring the right leg with you. Yeah. Good. So your arms on the inside. Steady gaze directly forward is going to help you with balance, yeah? Deep breath in. On the exhale, extend forward just until it feels good. So as soon as your spine starts to bow and your shoulder starts to pull forward, re-bend the knee. Yeah, you've gone a little bit too far. And then notice if all the strength is in the arm, and if it is, flex the toes more. So the hand is more like just a guide sort of here. Even effort. Deep breath in. Exhale, re-bend the knee. Good. Take it out to the side. Come into your tree pose. And maybe the foot is high on the thigh. Maybe it's on the calf. Just avoid the knee. And hands into the center of the chest. Good. Look towards the front eye level. Inhale, reach high. And exhale, drop the shoulders down. On your inhale, breath, start to take the gaze up towards the ceiling. Slowly. Good. Keep energy and activation where you need it, and then soften where maybe you're tensing. Then once the gaze is up, close your eyes. Even if it's just for a second. And even if by closing your eyes you know you're going to fall, close them anyway. Yes. And then smile. Don't take yourself too seriously. And come back. It's only tree pose, right? Let yourself wobble. Let yourself waver. That's how we learn, right? We think it's failing, but it's not. It's learning. So trust yourself enough to close your eyes again and keep falling again and again, coming back with just as much patience, calmness. One more inhale. Good. If it feels good for you, we're forward folding. So you can forward fold normally. You can forward fold in your tree pose if you so choose. So slow. You want to use the gaze to help you, your core muscles to help you, and then lower the hands all the way down, coming to your forward fold. Stay in your little tree forward fold just until it feels good. We'll all meet in the normal forward fold, so relaxing it down whenever you're ready. And then let the spine hang nice and heavy, pedaling the feet out, swaying the hips, swaying the shoulders. Yeah. And letting the body just be a little loose and a little floppy. Good, so moving to the other side. Inhale, halfway lift first. And then exhale to fold. Good. Hook your left big fingers around your left big toe. Right hand, right hip. On your inhale, all the way up to standing. Different side. So even though the mind knows where we're going to go, see if you can approach it like with a clean slate. And lift up a little more. Flex your toes so that that leg already has activation. Deep breath in. And then on the exhale, just start to extend forward till it feels good. As soon as you feel the spine round, you don't need to have that, the limb can be bent. Keep the spine lengthened. Keep your breath flowing. Deep breath in. Exhale, draw the knee back into the chest, coming into your tree pose. Maybe the foot is high this time, maybe the foot is lower this time. Hands into the center of the chest. And inhale, reach the hands up, draw your belly in. So when we draw our belly in, that activates all of our core muscles that wrap around the front, the sides, the back of our body. So stabilizing our spine, stabilizing our pelvis, helping us to balance here. Use your inhale, look up towards the ceiling. And even though you know it's coming, clean slate, yeah, fresh mind. Close the eyes. Close them. Feel yourself wobble. Feel that smile come over your face. And if it doesn't, ask yourself why. Like, why get frustrated or stressed or agitated over something as simple as falling out of tree pose? Practice being less reactive and calm. If we practice it here in a safe environment, then we have a better chance of taking those qualities, patience, gentleness, calmness, with us off the mat. Take a deep breath in. And exhale, hands into the center of the chest and into your forward fold. So you can choose to stay in your tree pose as you hinge from the hips and lower the hands towards the ground. Try it out. Maybe it's for you. Maybe it is not. And then stay in your forward fold tree pose for as long as it feels good. We're all meeting in normal forward fold. whenever you're ready.
And pedaling
the feet once you've arrived, swaying the shoulders, letting the body just relax and be heavy.
Yeah.
Good thighs.
Bend the knees a ton. Inhale, sweep up through chair pose, all the way to standing.
And exhale, hands into the center of the chest.
Okay, so this next one, a balancing pose, I'm just going to demo it real quickly because it's super common that when I'm instructing it, maybe we're going to look forward, and that just puts pressure on the neck. You know when you're in forward fold and you kind of look forward like, what's happening sort of thing?
That just compresses through the neck, and I really don't want that to happen for this one.
So the balancing pose we're going to do is in a forward fold. It's the same sign of kind of concept we have with our peace fingers, yeah? So in our forward fold, we're going to hook peace fingers around both big toes, yeah? And then with both feet, like one here, one here, and then the gaze will be just in front. So this triangle sort of pillar of strength, I guess, will help with balance, yeah? And we'll do both sides. So we're going to lean the body weight a little into one leg, soften through the knee just slightly, and then on the inhale, lift the opposite leg up, straight out towards the side, yeah? So it might work, it might not. But if you look forward, it's going to throw you off balance and just put pressure in the spine, like in the cervical spine. We want to keep that really long, yeah? So in your forward fold, you'll keep the spine nice and long, yeah? The standing leg will have a little bend in it, and then the other leg will just lift up. So we don't want to be, like, straining through the neck here. We want to keep the neck long, yeah? So you'll just lift up a little, and maybe you'll come back down. Maybe you'll lift up a lot and come back down.
But feel your energy moving evenly through both legs. If your lifted leg starts to become like weak, it's gonna make it so much more challenging, yeah?
So we'll use our breath, we'll see how we go. So in the forward fold, come all the way back down. Let the head be nice and heavy first. So give it a little sway from side to side. Give your body a little shimmy out, a little sway out. And then separate the feet. That hip distance usually does it. Peace fingers grip around your big toes. And take a deep breath in through the nose. Side out through the mouth. And again, like that, deep breath in. Side out. Good. Put your weight into your left leg, yeah? Good. And then on the inhale, just lift the right leg out to the side. Awesome, guys. Lengthen through the spine. And when you lift your leg, if your breath stops altogether, please breathe. So good. Your foot can come down as many times as you need it to. Again, that's how we learn, that's how we find our balance. So it's not failing, it's never failing. Just taking one more crack. And then slowly lowering the leg down with control. Good. Bending the knees quite a lot so you can flip your palms over and take them underneath the toes. So lift up your toes, place your palms underneath. Yeah. Gorilla pose, I think this one is called. And then you can bend the elbows or straighten, whatever feels nice. Let the head hang heavy. And just to give the wrists a little bit of a stretch out, the body a little bit of a lengthen. Release the hands. Inhale, lift halfway. Exhale and fold. Good. Peace fingers, hook around your big toes. Deep breath in. Exhale and side out. Again, love that. Inhale, breath. Exhale it out. Good. And then on your inhale, transfer the weight into your opposite leg. And then start to lift the left leg out to the side. Good. Both legs have equal amount of energy running through them. Both arms have equal amount of energy running through them. And flex your toes into your hand. Feel your glute muscles engage. Feel your spine lengthen. And just take it breath by breath. Yeah. One more go at it if you want. Nice, guys. Awesome. And then exhale to lower down. Oh, let the shoulders relax. Head is heavy. Any little sways or any little movements that feel good for you. And then from here, separate the feet, toes are out, heels are in, and squat down slowly. It's been a lot of forward folding, so squat down nice and slow. And then you kind of like perch the head on top of the shoulders. Use your elbows to open the knees, lifting the chest again, but relaxing through the glute muscles. And then you feel it, like that length in the lower back. If you keep your glute muscles really tight and your hips really tight, probably compression in the lower back. So soften, even more. But at the same time that you soften, lift the chest. And use your elbows just to increase. Take the hands wide, with elbows still just gently pressing the knees away. Look towards your right fingertips, and then inhale, sweep them all the way up. From here, you can stay or you can take a bind. So if you want to take a bind, wrap your right hand around your lower back. Nice. And then bend the left elbow around the front of the left shin. Nice. Maybe grab your fingertips, maybe grab a bit of pant or a bit of shirt, doesn't matter. And then roll the right shoulder more open. So rather than collapse, open up. Even widen the feet. Let the bottom feet soften. Feel the chest lifting. And breathe into all of that space in the front of the body. One more breath in. One more breath out. Inhale, open the hands nice and wide. So reach the right hand up. And then exhale to lower down. And other side, inhale, the left hand sweeps all the way up. So get nice and long first. Then exhale. Wrap the hand around your lower back if you choose to. But bend the right elbow. Reach around. Maybe you touch the fingertips, maybe you do not, doesn't matter. We all have different length arms, we have different twistiness, different hips. Wherever you are though, open the left shoulder just a little bit more and draw the belly in. Feel the butt sink down, but feel the chest lift up. So continually finding space. One more inhale. One more exhale. And inhale, reach up nice and high. And exhale to lower down. Hands out in front, but all the way down into the butterfly, soles of the feet together. And then lift the chest. Just take a little peek behind. Make sure there's enough room for you to recline back. If there's not, sort of like, I'm always reminding you of, you know, those dogs that run into bumps on the ground. Like, come all the way to the top of your mat just so you've got enough room. Is that what they do?
No, I'm just like,
I like that better. Each room is better than a dog with worms. Like, so in your butterfly, knees are nice and heavy, lift the chest up the chin. And then exhale, start to slowly fold forward with no effort. No effort. We want to keep the spine long. No pushing here. No fighting. Close your eyes, so then it doesn't matter how far you forward fold. Keep the spine long. Keep the chest gently pressing more and more forward. The breath is full and deep. The butt is anchored down. The knees are just gently opening out to the sides. One more deep breath in. Slow breath out. Inhale, gradually begin to roll up nice and slow. Bring your hands behind you. Fingertips can face anyway, it really doesn't matter. And then lift the chest again, like we did at the start of practice, I guess. So kind of, yeah, poke your chest forward and up and roll the shoulders down and back. So you lengthen through the sides and lengthen through the front. So you can stay here, or if it feels good, lift the butt and hips up and then press them just a little bit more forward. That'll stretch through the underside of the arms and stretch a little bit more through the inner thighs. The neck is long. Deep breath in. And exhale. If your butt's lifted, slowly lower it down. And cross the ankles over. Just come onto your hands and knees. Any little movements that you need to make, you know, like a cat-cow or a bit of a butt sway. And with your bolster, bring your knees together back into the hero pose, feet are wide. And then either sit your butt down onto the mat or onto the block and take your bolster like to your lower back. So even if you don't need it, more of a restorative hero, take your bolster and press it there. And then if you want to recline down, go slow. Elbows first. Tuck the butt under just a little bit. Soften through the glutes. And then maybe recline all the way back. You can take your hands all the way overhead if that feels good for you. But just ask yourself honestly if it does. And ask yourself your intention of taking your hands behind. Is it because you are forcing your body to open quicker than what it's ready for? Or is it genuinely because it feels good? And if it's because it feels good, then fully embrace it. Allow yourself to sink in. And since we probably can't help but to judge this pose or to judge ourselves, you might notice differences from the first time we did it. Maybe your body feels more open and it's more easy to relax. Maybe your quads feel tighter, and that doesn't mean you've digressed in any way. It might just mean now you're more in tune and you can really feel that. So feel what you feel. Don't try to force it to be deeper, or don't try and lessen it. Just feel whatever it is that presents itself in this pose to you. Unless it's pain, very good indication to change. Immediately, never question pain. Eyes are softly closed. Breath is slow and controlled. And getting ready to prepare for our Shavasana. But if you can, do it with your eyes closed. So you'll stay in the hero pose for no longer than maybe 3 to 5 more breaths at your own pace. And then you'll slowly lift yourself back up. You'll do whatever it is that you need for your legs, whether it's a butterfly, whether it's a hamstring stretch, whether it's a cat-cow. And you will slowly lower your body down onto the mat with control into your Shavasana. Head towards the back, feet towards the front. And then once you arrive there, you'll take any other poses that you need. So move slow. And see what it's like to move with your eyes closed. And how that might change the way that you move. How that might change what you feel. See if by keeping your eyes closed, you're more encouraged to move in a real, authentic way. You'll listen to your body rather than listen to me about what you should or shouldn't be doing. Body is so smart. It is constantly sending us signals, constantly communicating with us. Our minds are often so busy, filled up with so much information, that it's easier just to copy someone else. Easy just to follow someone else. Tune into what you need.
How many times do I have to tell you?
Do find yourself in the Shavasana. Let your body sink so heavy. Absolutely no effort in body finding.
little movements with your fingers and your toes.
Feeling these little flickers of gentle movement. Enough to reawaken you. If you drifted off, drawing back to this moment. Continue these little shimmers, these little flickers. Continue the deep full breath. Feeling body,
mind, and breath balanced.
Everything working in harmony.
Reach the hands all the way overhead. And point the toes all the way towards the front. Take a deep breath in. And then on the exhale, draw the knees into the chest. Roll over onto whichever side feels best for you. Whichever side. And keep the eyes closed. So stay with these feelings of restfulness, calmness, and peacefulness. Feeling equal amounts. Vibrant and calm. Your mind is clear. Body is relaxed. Heart is open. When you're ready, use your hands. Press yourself up. Come to sit in any comfy seated position. Bringing the hands to the center of the chest. Rubbing the palms together just to create a little bit of heat. And then place both of your hands over your heart and feel that warmth seep in. Knowing that there is something inside of you that is way greater than any obstacle. And bring the hands back to the center of the chest, rubbing them together again once more, placing them over the eyes. I'm just blinking into this warmth, allowing the eyes to adjust after being closed. Close the eyes before you remove the hands. Bring them back to the center of the chest. Sitting up nice and tall, deep breath in through the nose. Sigh out through the mouth. Namaste.